Episode 2. The Lost Lords. Hello, Mr. Crow. Eating maggots. Nice. Roderick Forrester, King's Road.
Damn the Forresters. That is so fucking far away.
That's far enough.
I come from the Tweeds there in the dead of House Forrester. Lordly tarts from the looks of them.
Alright, we'll take them.
Well, they're not free, are they? How much are you paying for them?
Sir Roland.
You are.
I know.
Some poor peasant dressed up like I am. A stable boy in clothes. You do this in just a minute, and you have the fucking stones to try to get...
No!
My house has suffered the loss of many good men. And you dare come here claiming to have forest to death.
The forest!
Leave. Now!
Fine! I'm doubling the river then!
You come back here again, you won't be leaving. You got that?
Aye, I heard you!
Now is a cheeky fucker.
Sorry, sir.
Don't worry, sir. Seven hours.
What is it, sir?
This one's still alive. You there? Who are you?
It's me. Roderick. Roderick?
Roderick. Gods, it is you.
Jesus,
sir?
It's you, Roderick. Where's the bloody knife?
My lord, you should not be awake.
The milk of a puppy. Drink.
Drink it. Drink it. Don't review it.
That.
Roderick!
I am at a very delicate moment in the surgery.
Please, I want to see my son.
How is he? Will he live?
Only if you let me finish my work. Sir, m'lady, I must insist that you leave.
Roderick, what have they done to you?
These wounds would have killed any other
man. Other man.
As it is, you may never walk again.
Roderick, what's wrong with you?
He drank the milk of the puppy.
Please don't leave me. Not yet.
Night-night. What is that racket?
Oh,
Good morning.
Good to see you again.
Roderick.
Yes, Roderick.
Woo. Brother, I thought I lost you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you.
Come here, sister.
How bad is it?
Broken.
Maester Tengren says your leg may never fully heal. And your face.
Ethan is dead.
Bruce Bolton's bastard came here and threatened to take me away. Ethan offered to go in my place. And that monster put a blade through his throat. Like it was nothing. Ethan? How can this happen to him?
We'll make Ramsay pay for what he did. I promise.
Good. We're planning to honor Ethan in the grove, alongside my father. And now Mother wants me to write this song for the funeral. I can't.
You can.
You can, darling. I know you can.
Been chaos here since he died. We have Whitehill soldiers stationed in our courtyard.
What?
Even the small folk don't feel safe. You need to show everyone who this house belongs to.
They need a lord.
You're still a hero to them. If you lead, others will follow. I know you still need time to heal, but...
Fine, tell him.
Council's meeting in the Great Hall right now, actually. Nobody expects you there, but if you think you're ready...
I want to go.
Can you even stand? They could use your leadership.
Who do you think I am?
Come on, son. You can stand. Go on. Go on, son.
I missed you, brother.
You can do it. Go on, you can stand.
You can do this, Roderick. I know you can.
Come on. Come on. No!
Fine. Why'd you do that?
I won't let anyone see you like this. Not when the house appears so weak already.
It's rolled in the corpse cap. The damage is done.
You're the lord of the house now. You must appear strong, solid. You can't do that on the floor. It's a long way to the Great Hall. You can't risk falling where others can see. Take my hand.
Let me help you.
Thank you, Talia.
Thank you, Talia. Ready? Come on. You can do that. Push up. Let's do it. Let's go.
That's it.
He's gonna fall again. Don't fall. That's a nice little...
Everyone will be so glad to see you up. Though I think you'll find that much has changed.
Come on. Roderick.
Castle Black. So this is the seat of the Night's Watch. The wall. Always wanted to see it, but not like this.
Recruits at the gate!
Jon Snow.
You arrived, what is it?
Another one for Frostfinger.
On a horse, no less.
Where are you, Jon Snow?
It's built by giants, doesn't it? You're new, here to take the black. Because you got that look about you.
I need to speak to the Lord Commander.
We, don't have one right now. It's Frostfinger you want. He'll get you sorted out.
Which one's Frostfinger?
That grizzled old prune over there. Says us new recruits are all dead men. But don't let him scare you. Just his way. You seem nice. That's not so good round here.
Hello, Frostfinger. I wonder
you're
if you're
Frostfinger.
You recruits. You come, you train, you fight, you die. Who are you, boy?
I'm Gary Tuttle, nephew to Duncan Tuttle, Castellan of Ironrath.
Gary Tuttle of Ironrath. And how does a Castellan's nephew get himself sent to the war? You're a thief. A raider. You abandoned your post.
I killed a man who murdered my family.
Then you know how to fight, at least. And you're no liar, either.
Sir?
From Duncan Tuttle, Castellan of House Forester.
My uncle wrote to the Night's Watch.
He goes on for a bit. Then he asked us to make you a ranger. As if it's a knighthood. So you see, Tuttle, I know all about you.
I know all about you.
You are a killing. Even if you are man enough to own up to it.
Yes, sir.
Now then, we'll start your training in the morning. For today, you need a cot and a cloak.
Understood.
Oh, no. Tuttle. Sooner or later, the Night's Watch will be your death. When it comes, try to make it quick.
Doesn't seem quite nice. I want to punch him in the face. What a dickhead. Unfamiliar faces.
Last we've heard, Asher was in Snaver's Bay, so Malcolm caught a ship headed for...
I heard they took him off a corpse cart! And he's missing his arms and legs!
At least he's still eating shit.
The Whitehead soldiers are drunk. And we have too few men to handle them.
Let's just get to the Great Hall.
Well, I say he's dead. And then dressed up some peasant in his place.
Fill me up, would you? And bring us some salted pork while you're at it.
Fill yourself up, you lazy fuck.
Is that him?
Has to be, doesn't it?
Who's hideous?
Had a run-in with Walder Flair, didn't
you? And he's leaning on a gurney.
Should have buried him with the corpses.
Forrest,
real shame about your leg, then.
Don't let go of your sister now.
We have business in the Great Hall.
Go on.
Move aside, soldier.
I'm quite comfortable, thank you.
And I don't think you're gonna make me.
What's weaker? Your legs? Or this house?
My men may be few, but they'll die before you keep me from my hollow.
Go on, my lord.
Come on.
It's ridiculous. You're treating them like that. Keeps their wits dull. Makes us look weak.
Both of you, please.
So you'd rather they riot?
You're a damn fool sometimes.
It doesn't matter what you think.
I was chosen as sentinel. My lord.
Roderick.
Come join us.
Hey, Tom, you should have told us the Lord needed help.
It's good to see you awake, Lord Roderick.
We didn't expect you so soon. The Maester said it would be weeks before you walked.
If you walked again at all.
It was highly probable.
Not here to talk about my oath. Perhaps we should get started.
Yes, let's.
Darlene's told me the state about us.
Then you know our situation is grim enough.
No thanks to your sentinel.
He's been beating the White Hill soldiers.
It keeps them off their guard.
They think you're a bloody fool.
My lord, please. Oh, I'm a fool. At least I was there by Ethan Sargon Ramsay's door.
I told you, I was keeping an eye on the Bolton soldiers.
You should have been protecting your lord.
Now Ethan's dead, and Ryan a hostage. I am your lord. Of course. Apologies, my lord.
The White Hills are my brother. We fight amongst ourselves,
and we should be fighting them.
We need an army to win that fight. If we don't have one.
Then find me one, sir.
That's no simple command, my lord. Most of our men fled after Lord Ethan was killed. And our allies are either dead or too afraid of the Boltons to help us.
You forget the Glenmores. You'd be wed to Elena Glenmore already, if not for the war. And her father is no coward. Now that you've returned, the marriage can proceed as planned.
The marriage?
Well, much has changed. The Glenmores may no longer desire the union.
Lady Elena will decide for herself. Your betrothed is on her way here as we speak.
Lady Elena?
She's coming now!
He's barely recovered. Why is she coming here?
She means to pay her respects to your father. but it could also be a chance to solidify our arrangement.
Wow.
If she still wishes to marry, we'd have the allies we so desperately need.
Their army would become oath-bound to Roderick.
We could burn that boy to the fucking ground!
Yes, this marriage could be our chance.
Of course, we must hope Lady Elena still wants to marry Roderick. Talking about a marriage, not an Ironwood contract.
I'll secure the father's armor, no matter what it takes.
Very good.
Just be careful not to push Elena too hard.
If Elena does come to Ironwood, she'll see those soldiers who caught you.
We starve them out, and they'll have to leave.
I'd rather they be lying around drunk than setting the stables on fire. My lord, perhaps you can put an end to this tiresome dispute.
Just handle it.
We could keep them fed, but take away their wine.
That'll be something at least.
Good. Now, there's nothing more to discuss.
Maester, it's time to light the iron torches.
Yes, my lady.
Yes, my lady.
Welcome back, my lord. It's good to be back.
Damn right when you look like Freddy Krueger. God damn.
Gregor last lit those torches when his mother passed. Ironwood doesn't burn easily, he told me. But Forrest is a half old man. And now we light them for him and Elizabeth. How is your song coming?
Ethan always helps me with music. It's not the same without him.
You're a fine musician, Talia. You do a great job.
Everyone knows how much Ethan meant to me. I'm sure it will honor him well.
About Elena, I've sent a letter to Nero. The Tyrells hold much influence over the Glenmores. I don't know where things stand between her and Lady Marjorie, but maybe your sister can find a way to help.
Holy shit, that's barricades! Barricades!
It's entirely ridiculous. If it's not the flowers, it's the food or the table settings.
Is that the letter to the orphanage?
Yes, my lady. It's nearly done.
Make sure to tell them we'll send all the leftovers. And something nice after that.
You and the children are ever in our thoughts.
A lovely sentiment, Miriam. And the seal. Here you are.
Yay! We done it.
Oh! Are there any more invitations to send, or are we finally done with the curse of things?
One more. An invitation to Sir Menon.
Ah, yes. One of my father's favorite drinking companions.
I have a letter for Lady Mira Forrester.
Thank you.
My pleasure, Lady Mira.
What is it, Mira?
It's from my mother. She asked that I help ensure Roderick's betrothal to Elena Glenmore remain intact.
How can you do that from a thousand leagues away? Ah, it's my help she's after, isn't it? She's a bold woman. Most would shy away from asking such things.
Forgive my mother. She doesn't see the harm in what she does.
She's not entirely wrong. A letter from me could encourage the Glenmores to honor the betrothal. But it wouldn't be very discreet. You'd be forcing their hand. That isn't the way I do things. You pushed me before and you saw the results. I'm sure your brother can secure the marriage on his own. I'd better get going. Mira, we'll talk more later.
No, don't do it.
If Lady Marjorie wrote a letter.
I'm sorry, Marjorie.
Sir Maynard, you are hereby invited.
Mira.
Lady Marjorie sent me to pick up the letters.
Sir Maynard. The man's breath smells like a brew house.
I was hoping I'd catch you in something slightly more exciting.
A love letter, perhaps?
Or a declaration of war? I know you're very busy with Lady Marjorie and all that's happening with your family. But I was hoping we could talk.
Game of Thrones.
If you don't mind. Go ahead, then. Well,
it's top off.
I know.
You've seen her?
A little bit. For like half an hour and then Claire picked her up. But I think she's coming back around. For you.
She's a savage, she don't care. Told you all, you'd watch out.
Oh, back here. You might be new here, but you're in my spot. So move.
I'm not moving.
Oh, fucking hell.
Most of you will be dead within the year.
Frostfinger is bloody speech.
If you want to survive in the Night's Watch, listen close.
You know why I got sent to the wall?
The wall was erected over 8,000 years ago.
Had this girl I used to fuck down again. Face like a queen, tits like a whore. Turned out she was married to some people. He tried to stick me with this. I was stuck in him instead. So next time I see him, you'd best fucking move.
Sure, for once, will you?
What's your problem? I'm sick of him bragging about all the girls he's fought. And what diacrom are you here for?
Potatoes.
You for potatoes.
What? No!
I stole them. That's what got me sent to the wall. Nobody cares, thief.
Don't call me that. My name's Cutter.
Cutter the potato fucker. There's one for the songs.
Boy, my sister was on.
Oh, I've got something for your sister.
Like I said.
Who in seven hells is you talking about? Top up. Who was it?
These two were arguing.
Not wise to point the finger at your new brothers, Tuttle. Garrett Tuttle here wants to be a ranger. So we can go north of the wall and die on some wildling spear. But what he wants doesn't mean shit. So today you're all gonna show me what you're made of. Can you swing a sword? Shoot a bow? Are you strong? Those who do well might just survive. Rest of you.
Frostfinger. I need a word.
Go on, get started.
Oh, Jon Snow.
Best of luck, Tata.
Here we go. Again. Bulls up. See those dummies? Those are bent.
You, the recruit. Scrawny, aren't you? See if you can carry one of these barrels over to the witch.
What's in it?
It's pitch. Dump it off the wall and it'll burn the wildlings down to their fucking bones.
Right. I can do this.
Want some help?
I'm thinking stew for you.
You can help Frost wash us off.
If the thing isn't frozen off. Oh, you're a prick. You know that.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, going that draw.
You're doing that all wrong.
Going that draw.
Man's ready to shit himself when he sees you coming.
Let me show you.
Alright, let's see if you can aim worth a wildling's arse. Shoot the targets I tell you to. Let's start easy. Middle dummy, center of the chest. You can follow orders at least. Next bolt, left target, head. Good. Right target, chest. Not bad. Center, between the eyes. One less wildling.
You hit all of them. Nicely done. Finn thinks he's so bloody clever. If a real wild man got his hands on fire,
he's just a bully.
Ah, he is. That's why I took this. Swiped it right off him. Don't tell, alright? I don't think they take it kindly.
I won't tell anyone.
I knew he would trust you.
I want the red one.
Yeah.
What, it's not red anymore?
I'll be sparring you today. Remember, these blades are dulled, but a sword's still a sword. Good luck.
Oh!
Come on, keep at it.
Like old Frosty said, not everyone's cut out for this. You're pathetic.
Cough. You didn't even try.
A crossbow's a coward's weapon. Besides, I could hit that dummy from here with my... Where is it? Where the fuck's my knife? If someone has it, I'll cut their fucking balls off.
How the fuck should I know?
You were the last one I showed it to. Well, you and...
It was you.
What?
You little fucking thief.
It weren't me.
Finn, Dawn. Give me my knife.
I don't have it, I swear.
Out of my way. Got it! Do something!
Fight!
Fight!
Get in! Wow, this is...
Yo, what is going on here?
Stole my fucking knife!
No, I didn't!
And Garrett defended!
The last thief I caught no longer has hands.
I swear, I don't have it. You must have hit it.
And you, I expected better, Tuffle. Instead, I find you doing this on your first bloody day of training.
Sir,
another word. You clearly need a few days scrubbing the latrines.
Crossfinger, I need another man atop the wall.
Fine, let him freeze his balls off. I'll deal with this one.
Get off!
Mind your fucking manners.
You, come with me.
Hey, let's go.
This way. I love King's Landing in the afternoon. The sun just barely kisses your skin. You used to love this place. Remember, we come listen to the musicians in the evening with Lady Marjorie.
You're right. It's beautiful.
Just through here.
Where are you taking me, bitch?
You will see. Queen Cersei's finest wine. Come on, sit down.
Where did you get that?
I know a boy who keeps the Queen's cellar well stocked.
Nobody will miss it, I assure you.
A little won't hurt. Suit yourself then.
So,
Oh, you're a thief, bitch. This bitch is a thief. She's robbing the queen's wine and shit.
this will do, Damien. Listen, if I tell you this, Mira has promised to keep yourself. You can tell no one. I want to trust you. I swear, I won't tell a soul. My mother was a handmaiden to Lady Lamora many years. She became pregnant. It was a disgrace to her family. My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
Yes. I'm fortunate to be where I am. I know that. But I always have to hide. I don't want to hide from you as well.
Was it your father? Who is he?
I don't know. My mother died not long after my birth.
Wow.
I'm so sorry, Sarah. I don't want to be Sarah Flowers forever. I need Lady Marjorie to arrange a marriage for me. It's my chance at a life. Did you have someone you'd wish to have? I'd have to convince Lady Marjorie to make the introduction first. I know she often confides in you.
Damn, bitches talk too long.
Sometimes when she comes to you wanting to talk, you might suggest she talk to me instead. Give me a chance to win her over. Coming from you is sure to be enough. Please, Mira. I understand if you can't commit to anything.
What have we here? If you need drink from that dragon, you're going about it the wrong way.
Not the finest arborette, but a favorite of my sister's.
Quite expensive for a hand.
I'd be curious to know how you got that. Since I'm certain my sister's going to give it to you, she won't even share with me. Though that's hardly surprising.
Sarah took the one from the cellar.
You?
It's always the quiet ones.
I suggest bringing cups. There are risks worth taking. Drinking wine stolen from the Queen Regent isn't one of them. Especially if you wish to have an alliance with me. Things have changed. My father has recently taken an interest in my mind. Most of the Royal Navy went up green flames. It must be rebuilt. He insisted I handle things myself. I'm on my way to meet representatives of Lord Whitehead.
Lord Whitehead?
He's hired a pair of merchant lords to broker for his house. It would seem Lord Whitehead wishes to sell the island right out from beneath your family. I don't know much about that, but judging by his upjumps elsewhere...
I will speak to House Forrester.
Perhaps you could. Come with me. These men think I have no choice but to deal with them. Imagine their surprise when I bring a Forrester to the table. It might be the first fun I've had in months. My lady.
We've been waiting here for an hour.
And can speak courteously in a merchant. Like finding gold in a chamber pot.
Who is this? Some girl you brought for entertainment?
My name is Mira Forrester.
Mira Forrester?
Why are you here?
A fair question.
We were told we would be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone. This is no place for a Forrester.
Perhaps you should ask Lord Tyrion.
I asked you.
She's here for the same reason you are.
I am.
I'm sorry, Lady Mira, but we've already spoken to you.
You spoke, I listened. Lady Mira has since persuaded me to consider her offer first. Now, if you'll excuse us.
You're going to dismiss me?
You can't do this. I assure you, I can.
This is a mistake, my lord.
I don't think so.
Lord Whitehill will hear of this. He's not a man to take such a matter lightly.
Lord Tyrion. Do let me know when you've come to a decision. I'd like the opportunity to change your mind. Lady Mira.
Good day, gentlemen. Well, that was fun. Now, as for your offer, what did you have in mind?
My lord.
The Crown's Iron Man. I assume you have a proposition. I had a reason for coming here. I know it wasn't just to entertain you.
I'm sure you already have a proposal in mind.
Say the Crown agrees to buy our island solely from you. Lord Whitehead will be left in the court. If he wishes to sell the crown, he'll have to do so for your family. You'll have to have your mercy. Or you'll bring your houses to open war. You do know that's a possibility, don't you?
Then that's a risk I'll have to take.
I'll consider the arrangement. Of course, you have to do something for me in return. Don't worry. The terms will be fair.
I need more than that.
I'll have an answer for you soon enough. We have an understanding.
Thank you, my lord.
This will either be very good for both of us, or very bad for you. For your sake, I hope it's the same.
My lady.
My lady.
I know another way.
You're coming with us then.
If you're to save your house, only more than the two of us.
You'll need an army.
That's why you're here, isn't it? To hire one.
An army of sellswords. And a man to lead. Do you hear what I'm saying?
I can lead an army.
No, you've always been. Your father was blind to me.
None of that matters without sellswords to hire, and all the companies around here are engaged.
What about Croft?
One-eyed Croft, with the second son. They're all with the Targaryen girl now.
But Croft owes me a favor.
I'm pretty sure he hates you, actually.
No. He'll help us. I'll make sure of it.
And how are you going to do that? He didn't part on the best of terms.
I'll be charming.
Right.
Well, this mother of dragons and her sellswords are headed north, so we make for Marine.
Wait, Marine?
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
We can't afford any distractions.
It's not your problem. It'll be fine. I promise.
It's fine. I trust you, Beska.
Beska, let's go.
I shouldn't have said anything. I said I was with you, little brother. And I meant it.
Ponte Renanis, Yunkai Heronchos, Vota, Costoti Dao.
Just one more we'll have to kill later.
Let's go.
You did well back there, Asher. You acted like a true leader.
You two can talk about it later. We need to get out of here. They won't stop looking for us.
It's a long journey to Marine on foot. I hope you're ready, Asher. It won't be easy.
Let's just get that army. I'm ready.
Good luck. Either we cross the narrow sea with an army at our backs, or House Forrester will not survive to see winter.
Wow. What?
I have information that will aid you with the enemy. Meet me in the gardens at midnight.
Wow.
There. That should last through Lady Elaine's visit, at least.
There's been no news from her. She may not have found a way to help with Elaine.
We'll be fine.
I pray you're right. Lord Glenmore's army could keep us from ruin. But Elaine still agreed to the marriage.
Remind Lady Elena that in terms of lineage, you are still
very much my friend.
Maester.
What of me?
Oh, make sure she knows.
If you are hurt, most ladies her age.
Enough, Maester. When we last spoke of Elena, you said you'd push to get her father's arm, and so you must.
Just remember that she'll want to see gentleness in you too.
I don't mean to burden you with unwanted advice.
Let me handle this, Mother.
You're right. I'm sorry.
My lord, she's here.
You really? I'm sorry for what's happened to you, Roderick.
Wait.
So, here we are. I'm glad to see you all about that.
Seems a lot to discuss.
Have you got one?
Yes, I suppose we do.
She gave me two. So,
one for me. Have one of them?
My father suggested I wait longer. I can't believe it's been 2 years.
Wait, give me one more part.
There's
three parts in one pack.
But now your house prepares for a funeral.
It's coconut.
Tell me the truth, Roderick. How are you really? And please, be honest with me. I don't mean to pry, Roderick. I want to know what you're going through. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have asked. It's remarkable that you're even on the moon. So much has changed since being a child. Playing hide and seek in the grove.
So easy to find. You're always in behind the same tree.
Maybe I wanted you to find me. But Roger, I need to ask you something. When I arrived at IMF today, your courtyard was filled with soldiers. White-hill soldiers. They said some terrible things. The White-hills are your oldest enemies, Roderick. Why are they here? Has something happened?
Trust me. They won't be here long.
That wasn't an answer. I'm going to be honest with you, Roderick. I have always looked forward to our marriage. But in light of what's happened to your family, my father was questioning the wisdom of our betrothal. He wants me to call it off.
And what do you mean?
I've been asking myself the same question. And frankly, I'm torn. Don't care about your scars, Roderick. I love the boy you are, and I can love the man you are. But my family can't get drawn into a war with the Boltons. They're the wardens of the North.
You and I can overcome anything.
I once thought so too. But I have to be practical.
Lena.
It doesn't matter how you feel. How can I ask my father to risk everything?
Because I love you, Lena.
I'm sorry. But I have to think of my family. I'm going to tell Father the betrothal is over. If it helps, we can delay the announcement. It'll give you time to get your affairs in order.
Deepest apologies, my lord. I tried to stop him, but
the rumors are true.
You have no right to just.
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore. You're not still marrying into this wretched family.
My father has not yet made a decision.
Well, for what it's worth, you can do much better than this cripple.
Get out. Now.
How rude of you. Your mother's the one who invited me here.
That's not true. I sent a raven to Lord Whitehead about letting Brian attend the funeral. But I never expected him to barge in like this.
She practically begged me to come. Of course, I'd want the same. youngest son home to mourn his dead father and brother.
If you hurt me in any way...
Bear no threats, Roderick. He's fine.
I just want to be certain that you know your place.
Lord Ramsay ordered your family to obey my soldiers until my son Griffin is from Peridot. But now I hear you're threatening them.
It makes me start to question your obedience.
Luck, enough of this.
Fuck your soldiers. Fuck you.
Roderick, please.
See, that's just the kind of arrogance I'm talking about. Sure. Here's the idea. We're going to make a fresh start. Your brother Ethan was so self-righteous, it made me sick. But you're a different man entirely. So, if you want Ryan at that funeral...
Sure, lady. Hey, you respect your better.
Kneel. Kiss my shiny ring.
Just do it, Roderick.
You don't want to end up like your brother.
I'm not kissing your ring. Do what you must.
Fine.
I'll just tell Ryan you didn't want to see him.
No, no, please.
And because of your defiance, I'm taking what should have been mine in the first place. The other half of the Ironwood.
You can't do that.
No, I know what Ramsay said. I'm saying something else.
As of today, I
harvest Ironwood from wherever the fuck I please. And you can't do anything to stop.
Would you defy express order from House Bolton?
I've known Bruce Bolton my whole life. As long as he gets his Ironwood, he won't care.
Well,
I have what I came for. I'll leave it to your business.
By the way,
my men have a name for you.
Roderick
the Ruin. Isn't that clever?
He's always been a brute. I'm just glad he didn't submit to it. You'd put your pride ahead of your family. What's Paul Ryan going to think? That we've abandoned him.
I couldn't kiss his ring in front of Elena.
She would have understood.
My lord, are you well?
God damn.
I'm going to kill that man.
You can't be fighting with the other recruits. You need those men to have your back. There's enough out here trying to kill us without trouble amongst our own.
It's Flynn's fault. I think he might be dangerous.
We need dangerous men for what's coming.
I'm Garrett.
Crossfinger told me about you.
Seems to think he might be trouble.
Not right.
He said worse about me. He said he fought for the north with the foresters. You were there, at the twins.
Yes.
I still don't understand. 3,000 men, and not one could save my brother. Why didn't anyone fight back? Why didn't they rally to their king?
The men were too drunk to draw their swords. The phrase cut us open.
Those cowards. Couldn't face Rob like men, so they stabbed him in the back. They couldn't even give him an honorable death. Let him die fighting.
Your brother would have won the North freedom. He deserved to be king. He was good at it.
He was good at everything. Now the Freys command Rivergun and the Boltons are wardens of the North. After what they did, it's not right.
I wish I could have killed them myself.
I keep thinking if I'd been there, I could have done something. But chances are, I'd be dead too. Whatever I once thought, my place is here. With the nice watch. There are those here who will hate you for who you are. Southerners who will call you traitor. Northerners who will call you craven. Some won't even have a reason. They'll hate you anyway. You can't do anything about it. Trust me, I know.
You can't just ignore them.
No good will come of doing otherwise. Most of the men are criminals, forced to take the black. You were a squire for a noble house. What happened to you today happened to me more times than I can count. I learned there's nothing more important than having brothers and sisters. I felt the same first time I saw it. I heard you want to be a ranger. Why? Why risk your life out there?
I want to protect House Forrester.
You'll protect them by doing your duty here. Not many recruits want to be rangers. They'd rather stay here when they think they'll be warm and safe. Mance Rayder marches on the wall with 100,000 Wardens. I've seen them for myself. The men here are murderers. Thieves, rapers. You won't like most of them. They won't like you. But they're your brothers now. Can you stand with them? Can you see past your differences?
I'll stand with them.
Glad to hear it. I'd say you'll get used to the cold. But you won't.
Come on.
Better get by a fire, or you'll end up like Frostfinger.
What? Now where am I?
Come out,
wherever you are.
Hello?
Where do you think you're going? At this time of night?
I was just headed back to my room.
It's a little late to get out, isn't it? Do you know what this uniform means?
It means you serve the Lannisters.
So, you must get yourself back to your chambers. And on me. Now! Don't like it, you can take it up with the commander.
Is there no way I can change your mind?
Did you not hear me?
At ease. The lady is with me.
Yes.
Enjoy the night.
I hope it wasn't bothering you. I'm doing.
Thank you, David.
It was my pleasure.
You got my note?
That was you.
I'm very glad you've made it. I've been wanting to talk to you for quite some time.
Did you search my room? What were you looking for?
Nothing, Lady Miller. I only wish to give you a note. I am sorry about this, Mira. But you've made enemies of the wrong people. A handmaiden should know her place. I'll make this quick and fast.
Late
to see you suffer.
Wow. Really?
Let her go!
You had no choice.
I need to get back. Someone might see me.
We'll take care of you. I know a few places in Cleveland. No one will ever find them.
Everything all right, sir? Damien, where are you?
Quinn Whitehead doing here?
No idea.
Hello, Roderick. Sir Roland. It's been a while since we've met.
Yeah. Last time I saw you, you were
okay,
brother.
Okay, off your ovary. You haven't heard Mum or Dad shout me out here?
Far long since I've known Russia.
You haven't heard Mum or Dad shout me out here?
That was a long time ago.
Why?
May we speak privately?
Were they shouting me as well?
Roderick, I came here because I know how hard these past few days must have been for you and your mother. I know my words probably mean nothing to you, but they're all I have. I'm so sorry, Roderick. Your brother didn't deserve this.
Neither of them did.
Listen, I know my father is intent on using violence as a hostage. But I think you deserve some music. I know it's little consolation. But if I can offer you this,
So you have no right?
Yes, as well. Not happy. Just knowing your brother is safe at Hartmont. I'm looking after him.
What?
The other day he said something that made me angry. He asked me if his father died because he was a coward. He asked if he was really a thief and a traitor like my father says. I don't wish to upset you, but... I thought you should know.
Mine is strong will, like father's. I will not know.
I'm sure you will not. He feels forgotten.
Alone.
He's waiting for his family, but every day my father tells him they will never come. That they've chosen their pride over him. And with each passing day, those words start to sound like truth. I thought you'd have more to say. Roderick, if you really want to bring mine home, this war has to end. You know that. We don't have to be enemies, Roderick.
Hello, Gwen.
It's good to see you, Talia. I hope I can count on your discretion.
Roderick, we should speak to Mother.
Mother. Come join me.
He should be here. He should be with his family. But instead they send her.
Don't worry. He's on the way out.
It's happening all over again. I can see it. My father's house was once mighty like this one. But his loyalty to the Targaryens cost us dearly. I watched as countless of our kin fell, saw our lands destroyed, and everything we clung to was ripped from our hands. I can't watch that same fate before this family. Our house! My children!
Our family is strong, Mother. We will not fall.
Many men are strong, and still your name takes them. You must be ready to defend us, Roderick. Your body may be damaged, but your spirit must be like iron. You let nothing stand in your way, do you understand? If you have to murder every last White Hill down to the babes in their beds, no matter what, you must do it. Promise me.
I will kill anyone who stands in my way.
Well, even a baby.
You must be ready. Promise me.
We will be ready, Mother. Meera, Asher, even Garrett, they all stand with us. He is strong.
Yes. I suppose we have to be.
Would you say a few words, Mama? Everything I wanted to be. He showed me what it is to be alone.
Goddamn.
He was so brave. I never knew you. But I am. I'm sorry. I love you, Father. My little brother. When I left, he was just a boy. But when his house needed him, he rose to the task like a lord.
He would have been proud. We honor Lord Gregor Forrester, my husband. Love. And our Lord Ethan. We speak to the Lord. Now is time to say goodbye. Father and Son are returning to the earth, to the ice. And from their sacrifice, new life begins.
I am from ice.
I am from ice.
Great voice.
Father, brother, I've sworn to guard this rest you've earned. I'd bare my neck to win in pain and swim the shivering sea. Paints the river's gray and gray.
Next time on Game of Thrones. Broadcast over.